That's a hard act to follow. This is a song that I wrote a year ago. It's about a time when I had two small children, and my daughter, Laura, and my son, Brant, and my husband, Tim, and I would go out into the woods and look for the perfect Christmas tree. And it's about that anticipation that we have that we would definitely find the perfect Christmas tree. So, and I want to thank Tom Haywood, who is accompanying me. He's done an amazing job. To be a perfect Christmas tree. Once we find it in the woods, Brant and Aurora, Tim and me, in the forest, in the snow, lugging axe and saw we go. It's going to be a perfect Christmas tree. First one is too skinny, second too bizarre, third we love to despite its size, which won't fit on our car. Fourth one has some branches, but only on one side. Fifth is small and kind of cute. Sixth is short and wide. It's going to be a perfect Christmas tree. Once we find it in the woods, Brant, Aurora, Tim and me, in the forest, in the snow, lugging axe and saw we go. It's going to be a perfect Christmas tree. Brant says that's our tree. Aurora disagrees. We argue and debate. The hour is getting late. Brant throws a snowball. Tim is quick to duck. Aurora chases me. And then we have some luck. Suddenly we see our perfect Christmas tree waiting for us in the wood. Brant, Aurora, Tim and me, in the forest, in the snow, lugging axe and saw we go. It's going to be a perfect Christmas tree. We found the perfect tree, not too big or too small. Everything our tree should be, by far the best of all. Tim crouches down, and Brant helps hold the saw. Aurora stands with me, where we can both woo and ah. It's going to be a perfect Christmas tree. Now we've found it in the woods, Brant, Aurora, Tim and me. Lugging the forest in the snow, lugging the axe and saw we go. It's going to be a perfect